Hey, welcome back to Solitaire Sunday. This is the last episode of this. So I put it on mastered or expert difficulty rather than hard difficulty. And it has started me off with a lot of things here. And I know I've been saying move the smallest number first. Probably should have. But I've got so many fours and only the 1-3. I was trying to uncover some. Maybe try to get something that I could actually see. I need to move. I don't have a bunch of fives either. I've only got the two. Hey, there we go. This is unusually open for an expert game. So I'm sure that that's going to change. And I ran out of things. I ran out of things on the low end. Six? Ooh. And I've got a king. I've already got a stack. This is a really lucky expert one because it's not actually all that difficult for me so far. I'm guessing the difficulty in this one's probably going to come from the draws because that does happen when you draw cards and they just give you a king and a king. If all the kings are hidden in this stack down here, then that means that I can't make stacks, but when they come out of there, they cover shit up and make it harder for me to actually move forward. So I do need to move things around and try to uncover the nine that is buried there, because that's actually what I need now. I need a five. Fucking eights. There's eights everywhere. I don't need more eights. I don't need twos either for that shit. Let me do this. Nope, that was the wrong thing to do. That's also not the correct thing to do. That was dumb. I don't know why I did that. Move that one. I got a seven. That five is what I needed so that I could do that, get the nine. But that doesn't actually help me all that much. I needed to move that king. And now I don't have any space for it. Another fucking couple of kings. Several kings. They do make that annoying for me, don't they? Also, I have no tens, so moving this nine doesn't really make a whole lot of difference to me at the moment. I do need sixes that I don't have. Three. And that's good. I've got an empty space. But that king is sitting on top of another, so that makes no difference at all. The double king makes that pointless to me. This double two is also useless to me at the moment. That seven can't go anywhere, so this eight is pointless. Fucking hell. I guess move that. That doesn't help me at all. What about this? It gives me an eight, which is also useless. I guess I'll do that. I don't really have a choice. I do have choices. That's why this game is difficult. The expert level makes it hard because it gives you lots of choices, and those choices can easily fuck you over. Get that over there. What do I want to do with the... I gotta move these sevens now, and I had a bunch of eights, but all of them are buried. That's where that struggle comes in, because now I don't have access to any of those eights, and now I have too many sevens. It does look like I can't actually move anything right now. Yeah. Okay. I need to get this nine out the way, right? But I want to move that three. No, I'm going to start with this nine, because that three opens up this jack, and that lets me get rid of this stack to move that. Perfect. Okay. I'm back to a mindset of, hey, maybe I could win this, rather than where I have been, which is, goddamn, I'm going to fucking lose. Move that. Let me see. Seven? Yeah, that works. I have a jack buried in here if I had a five, but Oh, you know what? No, if I move that jack, then I've got that 5 out the way. There we go. That gives me that space back. I'll move this 6 over here. And that gives me the king. Yeah. I might win this one. I said it started off really good and that it was going to screw me up. And it did screw me up. But I'm glad that I got screwed up in a way that I'm able to recover. That damn 8. It's useless to me again because now I've got this ace over here that I want to move, but moving that doesn't, like, this will open up a jack, and that doesn't actually help me. But I can move this ace, move this stack with the 8 on it down here. That gives me a jack, but I can't move the jack, and I don't have... Oh, wait. Let me see. That actually does mean I could get rid of that stack. So I guess that's what I ought to do, right? I don't think there's any better... Well, this would allow me to do that. And then still get rid of this stack. And now I have this section. I do still have that one at the bottom. I know I've got that deal down at the bottom. I don't want to use that. I want to try and avoid that any time that I can. This is opening up. That 8's actually useful again. It's good to have it be useful when I can actually use it. They're perfect. I'm uncovering more of these, which is where most of the difficulty lies in a deal like this. Get that. Oh, that might also kill me, though. I don't want to do that, necessarily. If I complete stacks, if I do complete stacks, then they disappear, and you will lose if you complete stacks and you don't have enough cards here in the empty slots, because I have to fill all of the empty slots in order to draw that stack down in the bottom. So I have had problems where I lost before like that. There's nothing I can do except for to sort of fill everything out. So nothing is hidden. These are all good. And there's still a king down at the end because they want to be assholes about it. And they put it right on top of a nice stack of them that I had. Fucking asshole. There. Now, I'm going to build this on top of here because I want to try and get as good of a score as I can. So, I need to build this up. I don't want to take away. There we go. That to here. To there. I'm not going to get, like, the greatest score on this, but I do get an 1183. On an expert game, that's, I think, about where I'm normally going to go. And I got to 208 today. I wouldn't have done that if I didn't do an expert game. I wouldn't have gotten that far. So I'm done. This is it. I hope you enjoyed this. This is the final episode of the final week of episodes of, like, one-off gameplay. So I hope that you enjoyed all of these videos for the last 7 weeks of videos, and you probably didn't, because you probably didn't watch all of them. But I hope that if you did watch all of them, you enjoyed them, and I hope that you'll come back for whatever's next, because I'm pretty sure that's a Monday. That'll be... What, Mountain Blade Bannerlord? Yeah, Mountain Blade Bannerlord ought to come out tomorrow for the first time in over a month and a half. So I'll see y'all later. Bye.